Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Today I'm going to be doing some smoked ribs on the Weber kettle with the slow and sear and the Weber rib rack. Check it out. All right, so a couple of weeks ago, I bought a Weber kettle, 22 inch, and the Master Touch series. I made a video, a couple videos of that. You can check them out. And then I went and bought this unit here, and we'll open it up. And then I also bought the Adrenaline Barbecue Slow and Sear 2.0. Haven't even opened it yet, but if you want to see that, I will have an unboxing video you could check out. These are the ribs that I'm using today. There's three racks in there from, happened to get these at Costco, but I believe they also sell them at BJ's. That's the price, and that's the brand. So I'm going to open them up, and I'll season them here on this aluminum foil, and then we'll get the kettle ready and do the use the slow and sear to do a slow cook. So this is what the Weber rib rack looks like with the packaging off, and these are some of the specs if you need to know a little information about it. What I'm hoping is that I'll be able to get the three racks of ribs in here with some space between them and not have them be too close to the slow and sear. This is the slow and sear itself. So this would be the side that's exposed to the rest of the grill, obviously. This is the water trough. It's now removable when you need it. And there you have it. All right, I'm gonna open these ribs, lay them out, and start seasoning them. Okay, so what I noticed with these ribs is that one of the three racks had the silver skin already removed, but the other two didn't, so I went ahead and did that. If you're not sure how to do that, there are quite a few videos out there showing you how to do that. It's the first time I've ever done it, or else I'd show you what I did. You gotta use a butter knife. Go check that out, it's pretty simple. I am only seasoning these ribs with salt, black pepper, onion powder, and garlic powder. I may put some barbecue sauce on at the end, but that's how I'm seasoning them. No special rub, just those seasonings. So let's get that put on the ribs. Some people will brine their ribs and things like that, or dry brine. This is the first time I'm smoking ribs in this Weber kettle with the slow and sear, so I am just going to season them now, get the grill fired up, and give it a go. And I've also noticed that when you have leftovers, you really smell that garlic powder when you take them out of the fridge to eat them again. All right, we'll flip them over and do the other side. All right, so let's set the slow and sear in there. So I'm putting it against the far side away from the handle because I'm going to have the thermometer on that side and the vent on this side. And that way, since I'm not using any other thermometers other than the one on the kettle, kind of relying on just keeping an eye on that one to get an idea of what my temperature is. In the future, I do plan on getting some good electronic probe thermometers and whatnot. But for now, first rib roast or rib smoking here, we're going to do it this way and see how it turns out. I'm sure it'll be just fine. So we're going to set it in there just like so. And I am heating up to boiling 4 cups of water, or a quart of water. And we'll put that in here once we get the coals in there. I'm going to be following the Adrenaline Barbecue Company's, the manufacturer of the Slow and Sear. I'm gonna follow their recommendation on how to do this to try to maximize my good results. So I am setting the vent on the bottom at a quarter open, and I'll be setting the top vent at one-third open. This is the charcoal briquettes that I'll be using. And the first step will be putting a lighter cube and 12 briquettes in the corner of the Slow and Sear and lighting that. Okay, so I've got the lighter cube in there and I'm gonna put in the 12 briquettes. All right, so what we're supposed to do here is light this and then we'll put a couple of these on top and get them stacked up. All right, so we're going to put some of these briquettes on top to get them lit. I'm gonna go ahead and add the water at this point. Alright, I'm going to add my hickory at this point. Okay. And now I'm going to put the grate on and get the ribs ready to put on. Let's get our rib rack on and put the ribs on. I'm not thrilled with the way the ribs are standing up, but I don't really have much other choice with three racks. So, I'm going to put the lid on and we're going to go from there. I'm going to set a timer for 5 hours. I'm going to come back in two and take a look. I'm going to open up the vents here on the upper kettle fully, just a little bit. I want to get the temperature up just a little, make sure everything's going well. And then I will close them as I get it to the proper temperature. Right now, looks like we're sitting at about 260, and I know being that it's right over the coals, it should be a bit hotter. So I'm gonna let it get up a little bit hotter and then close those upper vents back to a third. All right, so I had the vents open all the way on the top and the bottom one a little bit more open, maybe halfway, and I got it to about 400. So now I just lowered them back to where they were originally. Top vent at a third open and bottom vent at quarter open. And it's dropped about 375. So I expect it to come down a bit more and we should be good. I'm gonna keep an eye on that. It's only been about, oh, I don't know, 15 minutes or so far. So we've got a long way to go. And we've got some nice smoke coming out of her. Alright, so we're at the 2 minute mark here and the thermometer over the coals is registering at about 325, 330, something like that, Fahrenheit. So I'm going to open the kettle and just move the ribs around a little bit. I'm going to put the front rib in the back rib in the front, and maybe, not sure yet, turn the middle rib around in its same position in the center slot. But we'll figure that out once we take a look at how they're coming along. I've decided not to put the lid on the back here just to give you a better view of what's going on here. So let's get a closer little look here. So this is how they're they look at the 2 hour mark, you're gonna clearly see here that they're not as cooked because of the touching. I wish that wasn't the case, and I may have to figure something else out for the future, but let's get these resituated. And we still have 3 hours left anyhow. I think I'm better off doing it that way. Instead of using the front one, I'm using the two back, skipping one, and then doing that. Looks like I'm getting a little bit better separation. Next time I try it, I may decide to cut them into shorter pieces and possibly putting a piece or two directly on the grate. But let's get this closed back up and go for a couple more hours and we'll take a look. All right, so it's been 4 hours. We're gonna take the lid off, see what we've got going on here. And I'm gonna probably give them at least another hour, but we're gonna give them the bend test and also see what our situation is on the coals. The thermometer over here is reading about 240, which seems a little low, but let's take the lid off and see. So the ribs look pretty freaking amazing, but they probably do need more time. Let's get a look all the way around. There's still some unlit coal there, but maybe it needs some more air or something. So yeah, I might just lay them down on the grill. I don't know, let me see. Let's do the bend test on this one just to see where we're at. No. Nope. It's like the temperature. I mean, we got some shrinkage on the bones there. It just seems like they're not cracking. They're limp. Like we needed more heat or something. All right, I gotta get this grill a little bit hotter for this last hour. All right, it has been 5 hours. Let's take a look. Thermometer's at 300. Not sure if that's great, good, what, because I don't know what the temperature is over the ribs, but over the heat, it's over 300. So it's been 5 hours. We're gonna take a look and then decide if they're cooked enough and if I'm going to attempt maybe searing them or not if they need it. Let's take a look. All right, so they look pretty darn good. There's still quite a bit of water in the reservoir. There's still some more coals there. So timing wise, got more. So let's do the old bend test. I don't know if you can see that. So they're not really cracking, so technically might need some more time. So I'm gonna rotate that. Let's check this one since it was cooked closest to the yeah, that's cracking all right. So, check the middle one. Not as much. So, the one that was closest to the heat is definitely done. So I'm gonna put that in the back. And put the one from the back in the front. I left the one in the middle here in the middle. Pull these back a little bit. And just gonna stir up these coals a little bit. A little airflow in there. All right, I'm gonna cover them back up and I'm gonna give them another half hour. All right, 5.5 hours, let's see where we're at. Temperature is dropping to 250. Gonna leave them like that. I mean, I think they're done. Let's see. You can see the bend test. They're cracking, but they're not gonna break off where this one broke off. But it was also thinner. This one is, yeah. I mean, I suppose they are done. So, you know what? Let's just bring them in, cut one up, and we'll see how they turned out. All right. So here's the final result. This rack was closest to the coals for the second half of the cook. Is also a bit thinner, so this one actually tore right up, so those are probably going to be the most tender. And so I think overall it came out excellent. It was a 5.5 hour cook, and so now I'm going to cut one up and give it a sample and give you my honest opinion. All right, I'm gonna cut through this one here. You can see we've got nice shrinkage here from the bone. Let's flip it over. Let's give her a cut. Let's see what kind of smoke ring we got there. Not bad. Let's give it a taste. Good, but it definitely could have used more salt. It's fully cooked, nice and tender. Thumbs up. All right, so here are the ribs all cut up. Looking good. Take a look at that. Not bad for first attempt. Think I've got a lot to learn. But overall, I think the result is worth it. I might try two racks next time without using that rib rack and just lay them flat. This is probably more ribs than I need anyway, but they come 3 to a pack for that brand I bought. So we'll see what I do next time. All right, guys, I want to thank you for watching. If you have any experience with the Maverick, I think it's the XR50, new one from Adrenaline Barbecue, leave a comment. Let me know what you think of it. I'm thinking of getting something like that. This cook was a little bit tougher because I didn't have any way to gauge the temperature over the meat. Plus, the meat with that rack wasn't ideal. I'm going to have to figure out something different next time. Maybe either cut it into smaller pieces or only do two racks or something, because I didn't really like the way I was getting airflow. I think if I would have only done two racks, it would have came out a lot better, because they would have just been flat on the grill, and I think the heat would have traveled a little bit better. Another thing I would do also is put some foil on the what is the charcoal grid underneath the grilling grate to catch the drippings and stuff, because it actually went into the ash bin. If you have any experience with the slow and sear, whether it's the original or this new one, the 2.0, let me know what you think of it. And if you have any comments, hints, tips, leave them in the comment below. If you want to check out the slow and sear, there'll be a link in the description, and also this Weber kettle. So I want to thank you again for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.